from Seoul, Korea. My name is Sungwon Worsoni Kim, an associate professor and chair at the Department of Orthodontics at Gyeonggi University.
Hi, my name is Shinje Lee, professor and chair at the Department of Orthodontics at Seoul National University. Regarding mini plates, our study is the first study using survival analysis. Survival analysis is more informative than simply reporting a success or failure rate. We defined success to be when mini plates successfully provided clinical anchorage without any complication. Cases in which mini plates provided their intended purpose but still resulted with minor complications, we categorized as survival. Next, Dr. Sungwon Kim. He has been using the C-tube for more than 10 years.
Let me describe the C-tube first and then show a couple of treatment cases. The C-tube prototype was first invented by Dr. Chung in 1998. In clinical settings, the C-tube can be placed without complications due to its shorter fixation screws. The surgical procedure of the C-tube is straightforward. It is positioned and then anchored with 2 to 4 short titanium fixation screws after a small incision. The removal procedure is similar to the placement. Making a 5 mm vertical incision will make the removal of the plate easy. A few clinical cases can show the versatility of the C-tube. It can be used for en masse retraction and deep bite correction. A C-tube was used for mesial teething correction. Sometimes entry C-tubes can be used for closing open bites. Hello, Dr. Donatelli. Would you summarize the result and conclusion?
Greetings from Gainesville, Florida. My name is Richard Donatelli. I'm with the University of Florida College of Dentistry, Department of Orthodontics. The results of our survival analysis showed that after 1 year, the survival rate for mini implants was 96%. After 2 years, it was 91%, and after 3 years, 81%. The success rate, which is defined as mini plates that survive without any complications, was a different story. At 1 year, it was 92%, at 2 years, it was 80%, and at 3 years, it decreased to 43%. On the contrary, as reviewed in our 2010 articles entitled Survival Analysis of mini implants actually had increased survival rate and success rate over time. We suggested the reason for this is that mini implants probably osseointegrate. In this current study of mini plates, the most experienced operator had the best results. Second only to oral hygiene, the operator's skill at placing mini plates was the most important factor. However, for mini implants, the attributes of the patient is more important than that of the doctor. For example, patients younger than 15 years of age had an increased risk of mini implant failure than older patients did. In short, mini plates can provide more stable and successful anchorage than mini implants, especially initially. However, clinicians should use careful techniques when placing mini plates and avoid their long-term use due to increasing complications. Thank you for watching. Peace.